All right, how's everyone doing? I am Rich Cholenza. Thanks for checking out my channel. So what I want to get into today is my perspective on weight loss clinics or weight loss boutiques. I think you know what I'm talking about when I say this, and kind of me working with them and what I kind of learned from them. So some years ago, I ended up going to the East Coast, and I ended up spending 1 month with one of the major chains regarding weight loss clinics. They're one of the biggest in the world, and they were wonderful. I don't want to name them, but I basically was going in and out of multiple different locations throughout Manhattan, Brooklyn, Bronx, and Long Island that I remember, and Jersey. So not only did I get to spend a lot of time with them in their stores, learning about their process, I learned a lot of different things regarding nutrition and kind of how they're, you know, how they work and how they run their companies, which first off, I'm here to tell everyone, you know, I am totally not against any weight loss clinic. Anyone that can help anybody lose weight, fight obesity, get the confidence, you know, live a healthier lifestyle, I'm down with it. And I get to that a lot of times, they have to make money. That's the reality of it. They have to pay rent, they have marketing, they have employees and all these type of things, right? So, but what I'm gonna focus in on here is what I kind of tell people a lot of times is you have to have an exit strategy when it comes to fitness a lot of times. I talk about it regarding hiring a trainer, unless you're gonna become maybe a professional athlete. Even them in time, you know, eventually you are going to learn to work with different trainers, different doctors, different coaches, and all those type of things. And if you're the average Joe out there, a lot of times when you're working out or doing anything with your health, you've got to learn to maneuver. And when it comes to losing weight, that's one of the things I kind of focus in on a lot. People wanting to lose weight and kind of falling short on many different levels, and then eventually they end up going to a clinic that's going to help them lose weight. And we get it. I don't know if you know anything about them. They help, you know, they prep your meals. And it's kind of where a restaurant meets a grocery store, I guess you could say. And not only do they prep your meals, you know, they deliver them or you could pick them up, and it's all, you know, portion control, which is great. And it's for people who really just can't seem to do it on their own. Or from what I saw, a lot of people are wealthy or they're older and they just want things to be systematic, I guess you could say, or organized, I guess you could say. And which is great, I get it. And you know, if you have a ton of money and you like doing this for the, you know, for as long as you want, you're more welcome to it. But I think what happens to a lot of people, especially like say now during the coronavirus, when funds start to run short, you know, you can't always depend on living the same lifestyle you led before. So when it comes to maybe, you know, you being able to spend the money at a weight loss clinic, you may not be able to, you know, do that. You may not even be able to go in there at this point in time because they may be closed down. So then what do you kind of do? First off, food. I think when all is said and done, that is truly who we are, I think, to a certain degree. I'm telling you what we were born and raised and programmed to love. And I think food, especially with people that end up obese or overweight, it brings the most comfort to them. Just like anything else, maybe it got too comfortable and you loved it so much, you obviously, you know, you keep eating. And there could be many other reasons why you eat. It could be depression, it could be whatever the case may be. But food is such a massive part of our life because the reality is without food and obviously liquids, we will die. So the one thing you're never gonna stop doing is eating. I don't care, you could quit anything in your life, you're not gonna quit eating, okay? So let's just quit the bullshit on that. But when it comes to focusing in again on exit strategy, you need to find immediately what foods though you love, how you're gonna control those foods. I think by going to a clinic or a weight loss boutique or whatever you wanna call it, you're not gonna stick with that forever most likely. I don't care who you are. You may 1-2%, but in the long run, I think what happens is one is people get sick of that style food. They get sick of living that same lifestyle. They get sick of waiting for it to be delivered. They get sick of picking it up. And they just get sick of that place. And I'm not saying you can't go to another place, but I just think in time, from what I've noticed, most likely you are going to quit. And when you quit is where I think a lot of people have a problem, because now you've had somebody kind of taking control of every aspect of your eating habits, and now you lost them. So what do? You know, so my point being is if you're gonna use a weight loss clinic, I would just use it temporarily. While you're using the clinic, I would start learning how to obviously portion control, find out what you love to eat, find out maybe if there's healthier ways to go about eating that food, and be realistic. Take a realistic approach. You know what I mean? A lot of times too, I see people go, and I was seeing them, they go to these weight loss clinics, they weigh in, you know, they may lose some weight at the beginning. You have to understand that sometimes, you know, doing things slowly and consistently is truly the way to go. And I don't think a lot of people do that. And, you know, I can only speak for myself. I've gained weight, lost weight, and all these different types of things. You really got to study your own body, really kind of surround yourself in a household, you know, where everybody's a little bit on the same page. Because a lot of times if you're trying to lose weight and everybody else is in there ordering pizzas constantly, wings, or surrounded by a lot of fast food or eating out all the time and not eating healthy foods, it's going to be real hard. Now, I'm not telling you to change your whole family's dynamic by any means or go hardcore into it. But you got to learn the one thing again, you're not going to escape is food. I don't care if it's in your own house, restaurant, bar, grocery store, it's all there. It's impossible to escape. So if you are thinking of joining a weight loss clinic, wonderful, go do whatever you got to do. But you have to realize that most likely you are not going to be doing that for the rest of your life, especially if you're probably 30, 40, 50, whatever the case may be. Also, who knows if that company will even still be in business? Who knows if they'll shut that location down? Who knows, as time goes on, what your needs are gonna be. You have to realize that too a lot of times. You also may wanna take another approach, not just by eating, but exercising. Obviously, if you watch any of my videos, I'm always talking about, you know, how to, you know, not only go to a gym if you can, but if you can't go to a gym, take on any type of exercise, even walking, swimming, anything you can do physical, because sometimes a lot of people don't realize you may not have to go to a weight loss clinic to eat their foods. The reality is, again, not only portion control, you're just not active enough. So just by switching up and getting more active a few times a week, on the weekends, maybe doing some more, you know, fitness related things or just something fun, burning off some calories, you may be able to eat a lot of things that you do like to eat. You don't have to be that regulated. If you get a chance, you might want to check out my podcast, The Rich Talenza Show. I've been doing a lot of different podcasts with people that have had issues with gaining weight, losing weight. I've had a lot of nutritional experts talking about many different things. I even had a girl on there that was 300 pounds, dropped down to 130. I've had guys that were over 300 pounds, now they're 200 pounds. So I've had some really amazing stories. And on the flip side, I have some people on there that have been struggling with their weight. I'm about to post one of those as well where, you know, a lot of times we have issues with our weight and we have an eating disorder. So it is something you may want to check out as well, is what I'm saying. So I'm also on LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. So please stay healthy, and that's all I got for you. If you get a chance, subscribe. Take care, and stay healthy.